I was reading, I watched on YouTube, I was reading a Surah Jinn.
Yeah.
Yeah, so one of the comments, he said, Allah challenges people in the Quran to bring a chapter like it.
Yeah.
And the comment basically said, so Surah is the jinn speaking, right? The Surah. So basically the person said, that's a contradiction because the jinn speaking the same eloquency of the Quran as Allah speaks in the rest of the chapters, in that chapter.
No, Allah's narrating what the jinn said. Allah's narrating it.
But it's not what the jinn said, it's not the words.
That's the word. If I say it to you, if you say something in English and I translate it in Arabic, that's what you said. Yeah, but you said in different language, but that's what you said. If you said in English, I'm going home, and I said, قَالَ وَدَهِمُ الْبَيْتِ. You said that, no one's gonna say, if you know Arabic, yeah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's why about Musa, Allah mentioned it with his own kalam, subhanahu wa ta'ala, with eloquency.
Yeah, and another question, I know the Qatar World Cup is starting today. People have been talking a lot about, you know, how they get feeding the workers, all the deaths and stuff. So I just wanted, like, I don't know.
Well, I don't know, Akhi. I mean, you know, the Western world, if they want to make someone as an enemy, they will say anything, you know. I mean, I don't know. I can't comment on something I'm not sure. I mean, like, how many people died in Palestine? How many people died in many countries? You know, subhanAllah. Now when Qatar wants to have the World Cup, everyone's talking. You know, before that, people were not dying in Qatar. The workers were not dying in Qatar before that. You know, this is, even with agree with football, I used to watch football, but I don't agree with football anymore. Because football has been used, football to some people is like worship, ibadah. You understand? One of the Muslim scholar, he mentioned, like he wrote a book about football, that football became like a religion, deen for people, subhanAllah.
Yeah, in this country especially.
It's everywhere. I used to watch football. I don't want to speak on camera. I used to carry a big knife. Like we're going to war, man.
Yeah, no, it's crazy.
It's crazy. We used to go, we're young. I was 14. I know about my neighbor, 17. He had a big knife. He put it in the bread, you know, the bucket. He put it inside the bucket. It's like we're going to Quraysh. Do you understand, Akhi? MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Allahumma ghaytha nafi'an. Allahumma ghaytha nafi'an. Allahu Akbar. May Allah bless you, Akhi. What's your name?
Anas,
Hayyak Allah, Akhi Kareem.
You know, I've been meeting because I've been seeing your video for like 3 years now.
Yeah.
Yeah, a couple of weeks ago, I had a dream. I was massaging.
Are you in my masjid?
Yeah, and you were giving a lecture.
So. Alhamdulillah, inshallah, khair, inshallah. You know, I'll tell you something about dreams. A man came to Imam Ahmed. He said, yeah, Imam, I saw you in Jannah in my dream. So he came to Imam Ahmed. He said, I saw you in paradise in my dream. He said, no one should be deceived by a dream. He said, there was a guy who people saw him in Jannah and he died as a Khariji. Khariji is someone who believes the blood of the Muslim halal. You see? So, you know, we say Alhamdulillah, but we don't live our life based upon dreams. Yeah. And sometimes, you know, when you see dreams, it's completely the opposite. You know, Allah, you see a dream, Alhamdulillah, you know?
And
sometimes, yeah. Assalamu alaikum.
I just want to talk to you 1 minute.
Yeah, I'm speaking to you. Yeah, assalamu alaikum, akhi. How are you, my brother? You good? Yeah, inshallah. Khalas, inshallah. 1 second, yeah? Yeah, inshallah. So, yeah, alhamdulillah, akhi, man. With the call, dreams can be good. But, you know, like, you know, the Christians, just side point. The Christians, they say, I had a dream, I saw Jesus. Yeah? That's not criteria. Make Christianity right. Like someone said, I had a dream, I saw Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You can't tell a Christian, I had a dream, I saw Prophet Muhammad, therefore Islam is true.
One last thing, you know, we don't speak about the leaders of the Muslim leaders in a bad way.
Yeah.
Is there a way to speak about, say, something that they did wrong without rebelling against them, like coming under that category?
Okay, when the Muslim leaders, I want to make something clear, okay, for everyone to understand. When the Muslim leaders does something evil, for you or me to speak out, what is the purpose? Because as a Muslim, when we speak, there's a purpose behind it. You know? We're not like crazy people just speak, yeah? So when you want to speak about it, it's to advise, you know, to warn people against it, correct? Okay. I'm in Britain. Something happened in Algeria. Yes? I mean, I can advise my Algerian people. But why do I have to mention the leader? Is my concern for people to not fall into the sin? Or my concern, people say Shamsi is a brave man, he speaks about the leader. Which one is it? Am I doing it for Allah's sake or am I doing it to please the people? If you're doing it for Allah's sake, go to Algeria in front of the leader. Say what you've done is wrong. And also, you do it in a correct manner, in a good way, you understand? Because why? Firstly, what do you want? You want the leader to accept the advice. You understand, akhi? So these people who are in America or Britain speaks about something happened in Saudi, Algeria, Morocco. What is your intention? Is your intention to warn the Muslim against it? MashaAllah, Allah reward you. Explain to them, no doubt. But when you start specifying the leader here, and we have a text from the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. If you have advice, take him by his hand, advise him. You understand? Because, you know, you in America speaking out against him and shouting, what are you going to do? You're going to put hatred in people's hearts. And that will generate what? Revolution. And that's what happened to Uthman ibn Affan. So some Muslims, they pretend that they want khair for the Muslim, but his main concern is speaking about the leader. When Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, take him by hand, advise him. So how we do it? If you're in a Muslim country and the leader start doing haram, you know, you start refusing the haram, say, stay away from it. But now some scholar said, if it's a person well respected, and if the leader, if the Muslim scholar in the Muslim country is well respected, and he mentioned the leader, said, listen, the leader is doing is haram, and the leader will accept it, then alhamdulillah. Because there's exceptions to it, you know? But as for just shouting, screaming, you know, it's not the way of the, like, you know, the leader is taghut, the leader is this. What you want to do is show people, oh, I don't, oh, see, I'm not scared. We're in America, tell me you're not scared. You're in Britain, understand? And you know, wallahi, akhi, what's happening in the Muslim countries? Wallahi, alhamdulillah, there's khair there, no doubt. Naham, you can go to masajid, you can go pray, alhamdulillah. The what do you call it? The security and safety, alhamdulillah. Now, I'll tell you, akhi, Khawarij and Rafida, these two people, they don't like to see Muslim countries stable. They don't like it. They love to see Muslims kill each other. Wallahi, I've noticed that. For example, let me give you an example. Saudi. You know, the people hate Saudi, and I love Saudi. May Allah reward them, you know? You know, I was, akhi, do you know how many Quran they print yearly? 100 million Quran. Mushaf that you read. But no one speaks about it. You understand? You know? So they speak about Saudi, okay? Now, is Saudi perfect? It's not perfect, okay? Their security, their safety, people going to Hajj. Anyone attacking them, robbing them? No. Alhamdulillah, safety, there's hotels, you know, people welcoming you. MashaAllah, you have the, what do you call it? The AC, everywhere AC. You have everything, you know, make sure everything's clean, clear, MashaAllah. You do what they do, they say, oh, there's haram here. Look, you know, akhi, what about the goodness they did? You forgot goodness, you understand? So we say, alhamdulillah, okay, there's a lot of khair. There's some evil here, how to deal with it? The Sunnah way, advise, you know, that the Muslims stay away from it. Make dua, may Allah guide the Muslim leaders. Alaykum salam. Advise the Muslim leaders for the scholars, and better than what happened in Libya, what happened in Syria, what happened in Yemen. But like I said, Khawarij, they hate Muslim countries to be stable. Like the Khawarij in Algeria in the 90s, they destroyed the Muslim countries in Algeria. They destroyed Algeria by civil war. Where they went? They came to Britain. They came to a country with their security and safety. So Khawarij and Rafida, they are the best friends. Yes, they maybe fight each other for territory and so on, but they are the best friends. That's why one of the right hand of Bin Laden in Sudan, he said the head of the Qaeda used to go to Iran. Hold a minute. How are you going to Iran?
زواج بن لادن. إيران.
أخي.
زواج بن لادن.
The marriage. In Iran.
No, Al Qaeda in Iran.
سبحان الله أخي. But you know that's why I noticed. Me, I love Muslim countries, and I love see Muslim establishing Sharia in their countries. But before that, Tawheed first. Iran, they have Sharia. They cut off the hand and all of that. But Mushrikun, they have a shirk. You know. But I want to see Tawheed first. You know, and step by step. Barakallahu fikum. That's why.
Every country has you know,
bad, good, Barakallah fiqh.
No country
perfect. Wallahi, akhi, you know, but you know why they focus on Saudi? No, because even some Salafi brothers, I told them, akhi, listen. They say, akhi, you know, people think you're always defending Saudi. I said, I defend that country, alhamdulillah. They don't give me a penny. Barakallah fiqh, you see Tawheed there, Sunnah there. And the people that hate it, they hate Salafiyah. And they're attacking them because they want to see that country destroyed. And if that country is destroyed, wal-iyadu billah, you see the fitna will happen. You understand, akhi? I mean, look, have you heard in your life Saudi guy who's under the truck coming to Europe? Have you heard Saudi, Emirati, Kuwaiti? I never heard Kuwaiti, Saudi, Emirati died in the sea, or he coming under the track, illegal immigrant to Europe. They come with respect to Europe. You know? But other countries, what happened to them? So why you want to destroy the country? They have mistakes, may Allah. But we disagree with these mistakes. And it's haram. But how do you advise them? You know, barakallahu fiik. But like I said, wallahi, take it from me. Rafida and Khawarij, they hate Muslim countries.
Yahud,
all of them the same. The Zionists with them. So, what is the best thing? Like, for example, now, on a day of judgment, Allah will never ask you about what Mohammed bin Salman did or Algerian prison did. That's beyond your ability, capacity. But for sure, Allah will ask about your prayer. For sure, Allah will ask about your children, if you have children. For sure, Allah will ask about your wife, if you have a wife. You know? So, the you know us, some Muslims, yeah? He doesn't pray. And always leaders. But brother, for sure, Allah will not ask you for leaders. But Allah will ask about yourself first. You understand? So, alhamdulillah, we're for Sunnah to Nabi alayhi salatu salam. And Nabi alayhi salatu salam taught us how to deal with it. And what's happening now, there is a movement. They want to make men, there is some Muslims who are day and night lying against Saudi and Egypt. Day and night. Lying against Saudi and Egypt. Why? Because these two countries, and there's other countries, Algeria, where they have a strong army. And if we destabilize these countries, what happened to the Zionists? They'll be very happy. You understand, akhi? Look what happened to Iraq. I mean, like Yemen. Would you live in Yemen? Akhi, you know when a civil war happens, many people don't know about civil war. When there's civil war, you can't even trust your neighbor. Because it's civil war. Like, same people fighting each other. Your cousin can be someone defending, like in Algeria 90s. Your cousin can be with a terrorist, with a Khawarij, and he believe your blood is halal. You walk in with him, he turns, he kills you. There's no trust. There's no security. There's no safety. What is it there? Just fear. Anxiety. So these Khawarij are in Britain, enjoying their life, and they want our country to be destroyed. Alhamdulillah. Many Salafis are in Algeria. Some of them are poor. Some they have no job, but they say, wallah, it's better off to be like this than to be like Syria or Libya. You see it? Because that's why there's a fitna, there's oppression, but when the people rebel, oppression become widespread. How many Syrians died in the sea? We never heard that before, that thousands of Syrians that were running from their country, or Libyans, barakallahu fiik. So wallah, I have to repeat again, the Khawarij and the Rafida are the best friends. And they hate to see Muslim countries stable. They want to destroy the Muslim countries. Oh yeah, Allah Azza.
سألك
الحلبات. بس
سميتي
عبد الله من المغرب. الله يحييك عبد الله.
الفيديو ممكن تدير واحد ديكاس لخويا حيت خويا اللي وراه
يعني الفيديو نرسل له فيديو
غير واحد ديكاس رضوان
متوكل هذا راكم بدا
فيديو
السلام عليكم خويا رضوان
الله يحفظك
الله يحفظك خويا رضوان الله يعزك معك شمسي ان شاء الله راك لاباس خويا سلمنا على الفاميليا وكاع ان شاء الله هو وين راه
ان شاء الله هو في المغرب
في المغرب فين في المغرب
اكادير
ما شاء الله
في مزيغن السوس
ما شاء الله اللهم بارك الله السوس ما شاء الله الله يعزكم بارك الله فيك الله يعزك بارك الله فيك Yeah, sorry, Akhi. So, alhamdulillah, you know. And look, like I said, I challenge the Khawarij and everyone. Anyone, let's bring the book of the Salaf. And who is following the Sahaba and who is not? The Salaf or Salih. Let's bring also the Sunnah Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal Shaybani. Shrah al-Sunnah Imam al-Muzani. Shrah al-Sunnah Imam al-Barbahari. I'tiqad al-Sunnah Imam al-Lalakai. These books was written by scholars from the Salaf. Or scholars who was writing down the aqidah of the Salaf al-Salih. And let us see what's following the Salaf, who is not. Challenge, come out. I've been challenged for 4 years, akhi. No one's coming out. Alhamdulillah, well, I go back. I remember maybe 5 years ago, I made a video when I mentioned that our aqidah when you go to Imam al-Barbahari. Who is Imam al-Barbahari? Is a student of Imam al-Marwazi. And al-Marwazi is a student of who? Ahmed bin Hanbal al-Shaybani. Ahmed bin Hanbal al-Shaybani is a student of Imam al-Shafi'i. Imam al-Shafi'i is a student of Imam Malik. Imam Malik is a student of Nafi' Mawla Abdullah ibn Umar ibn al-Khattab. And Nafi' is a student of Abdullah ibn Umar ibn al-Khattab. Abdullah ibn Umar ibn al-Khattab is a student of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam. And the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam receive the revelation from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. That's our عقيدة. Speak to إخوان المسلمين. He goes to Hassan Banna. Speak to Tablighi. He goes to his name, Muhammad Ilyas. Yes. Alhamdulillah, that's our عقيدة. Speak to Dubandis. He goes to Abu Mansur Maturidi. Our عقيدة goes back to the Salaf. That's why no one is. Let's bring the book of the Salaf, the books of the Salaf. This challenge for anyone in Speakers Corner and outside Speakers Corner and around the world. Let's bring the books of the Salaf and you see who's following the Salaf, who is not. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, that's from Allah's blessing. Not because I'm smart. Allah blessed me with the da'wah Salafiyya, as-Salaf al-Salih. Because the Salaf, may Allah have mercy upon them, have written down the Aqeedah in order for the Muslim to not be confused. Barakallahu fikum.